But I had something happen to me that has never happened before.
Diarrhea?
Yeah.
Where?
While I was running.
Ay vey.
Oh.
Where were you?
I was out in California staying at a hotel.
And while you were running, did you just eat something and then go running?
No, it was early in the morning. I hadn't eaten anything. I woke up, my stomach was a little queasy, but I thought everything was cool.
So what were you wearing?
I was wearing, you know, those little bicycles.
Yeah, you always wear bike. That's good. That at least holds in the diarrhea.
Oh.
Doesn't? What happened?
Not did you, diarrhea.
Did you release?
I was ending my run. All I had.
How many miles did you do?
I did 5 miles.
Wow.
And I was just about to go back to the hotel. I was maybe 3 blocks from the hotel.
So close.
So close, and yet so far.
Oh, hey, that's embarrassing.
And I'm like running, and all of a sudden I say, you'd better stop running right now, because any more landing is going to be bad for you. So now I stop running, and I start walking really fast, trying not to jar myself at all.
Right.
And at a certain moment, it didn't matter.
Really?
What I was doing.
Oh, my God. Was it a lot of diarrhea?
It was an explosion.
Ay vey.
Like a nuclear, you know,
wow, like Greta Weitz.
That's how I felt, because I was like, I don't want to be Greta Weitz. I don't want to be Greta Weitz.
Were a lot of people around when this was happening?
No, because it was early. Thank goodness.
What time of the morning?
It was probably around 7:30, something.
People
like
are
that.
Out that time.
Not in California. They don't get up that time. So
so you
I'm running around, you know, just there was nobody on the street, just people driving a couple of cars or whatever. It's a remote area.
But what about when you walk into the lobby of the hotel?
Wait a minute, because that's the whole thing. When I closed the door as I was going out for my run, I locked myself out of my room.
Oh, no.
So
oh, no.
It was going to be mandatory, you know, for me to find a way to get in my hotel room.
Oh, my God.
I couldn't just run in, because it wasn't like a lobby situation. You could actually just go to the door of your room.
So, wait a second. You go running. Okay, you walk. All of a sudden, it you get to the point where it doesn't matter. You really release into your pants.
I released.
Is everything coming down your leg?
Yes, it was.
Whoa.
Just
oh.
A stream.
And you stink? I mean, you got to be smelling.
I couldn't smell anything, because it was a nice breezy day.
Were you with anyone, Mr. X? No.
No, I was out. I went there with a friend of mine. So I was just, she was, thank God she was back in the room. We had adjoining rooms.
Oh.
And because I'm thinking, if she's not in her room, I have to somehow get to the lobby. And at this point, I can't even continue to walk.
Is it apparent that it's all over your legs, or?
I'm looking, and I've got white socks that are now not white. And so I saw a guy. I said, I have to do something. I can't go anywhere like this, because I couldn't even walk into my hotel room like this.
Oh, my God. Listen to you.
I'm telling you. And so anyway, I saw a guy who was watering a plant.
Yeah.
With a hose. Because I was like, all the sprinklers were on when I left. No sprinklers were on when I was coming back. Because I'm looking, I got to find some water.
You went to the guy with the hose and asked him to hose you off?
I said, this is what I have to do. And I didn't ask him. I said, can I borrow your hose? I'm standing on the street, hosing the lower half of my body down.
Oh, my
and
God.
And washing off the socks and the shoes so that I can at least get the next block. And so I tried as hard as I could to hose everything off. I was just spraying myself with water like I was taking a shower.
Did the guy think you were weird?
No, he just walked away, gave me his hose and walked away. And I was like, I don't even know if he knows what I'm doing. I just have to do this. And thank God, I'm sure he has no clue.
Was there a big stain in your back of your shorts?
No, they were black.
Right.
So you couldn't see anything.
Yeah, I've seen you in those shorts.
So I was washing and washing and washing and washing. And finally I thought, okay, I think I'm good to go. But there was, I guess, still remnants, because, you know, half a block into the walk, I see brown things happening on my socks again.
Oh, my God.
My own.
And so I go to, you know, my travel mate's door, and I'm pounding on her door. She's in the shower.
Oh.
I'm like, I got to just pound and pound and pound until I get her attention. So finally, she hears something, and she jumps out of the shower and comes and runs and opens her door, and she wants me. I said, no, 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 just go open my door and then leave. And
she's probably like, there's Robin, giving one of the weird commands again.
Yeah.
I know, because
don't
she opens
boss
the door,
me around.
And I go, no, go, go. I had a terrible accident. And so she runs out of the room, and I have to go just jump into the bathtub completely dressed before I can even...
How'd you clean your shorts? Did you just throw them out?
I threw everything away.
You did?
I just took it all and chucked it.
Did you have another pair?
Of course.
No. Wow.
I just had to... I threw the shoes, everything. Everything was ruined.
The footprints up to the room.
Oh my God,
how embarrassing. But at least you throw to the hose. I don't know if I'd have the balls to get the hose.
You would have, because I would never, if it wasn't absolutely at that point. At that point, I had no choice.